Hello everyone, my name is Kenneth Hami and I am going to start this new course on Udemy with the name of JavaScript and jQuery Making Interactive Web Pages. I'm not sure how many hours this course will take, but I will do my best to cover every function on jQuery. We will start first basics of programming using JavaScript, then we will use these techniques to learn how to use jQuery to make animated pages or interactive GUI. I hope you enjoy this course. Let's begin with the first lesson. Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number one. We will talk about JavaScript basics in chapter one and chapter two. After that, we will in later chapters, beginning with chapter three, we will talk about jQuery library. After that, after we have finished, after we will finish jQuery, we will talk about jQuery UI, and in the later chapters we will talk about advanced techniques. So let's begin with the basics of JavaScript with this video number one. So we'll create basic page by typing doctype.html, and we'll start simple web page HTML. After that, we will define our head, so we have another title inside this head. After that, we have the body, which contains all the contents of this page. Inside title, we will, let's say, lesson number one. So to link JavaScript to HTML page, you can define JavaScript code internally in this page by typing script in HTML5. No matter to delete this attribute, which is type, but in HTML4 you must type this type text slash JavaScript. So I am using HTML5, so I will delete this attribute, and we will start by defining some variable. So to define variables in JavaScript, you must, let's say, variable number equals 3. Then we will say document.write, let's type this number. And every line in JavaScript ends with this semicolon. As usual, every line is called a statement, and every statement must end with this semicolon. So we have written our first code. Let's save this web page and run this web page in the browser. Personally, I am using Google Chrome to testing my web page and testing my code in JavaScript. Feel free to use any web browser like Opera or Internet Explorer or Firefox. If you refresh or open your web page in the browser, you find that it types number 3 in this web page. So to finish our first lesson, we must say, I have created a comment here, and you must say the rules of creating variables, rules of creating or rules of defining variables in JavaScript. Rule number one, every variable must start with dollar sign or underscore. Rule number two, every variable's names must contain letters only, and the numbers and dollar sign and underscore. Rule number three, variables names are case sensitive. That means, let's say, score in small don't equal score in capital letters, and rule number four, avoid key words. That means you shouldn't never ever include any keyword into your code by defining these keywords which are reserved to JavaScript. You mustn't never ever include any keyword into your naming of variables. To know the all keywords of JavaScript, I have included PDF file in this chapter 1. Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number 2 in JavaScript course. In the video, we are going to continue in what we have started in the last section, in the last video. Now, after we have said about how to define variables in JavaScript, we'll see here how to implement math operations in variables in JavaScript. So, if we want to operate the we want to make math operations in JavaScript, so let's define, we have number one variable, and let's say this variable will be 45, and we have variable of number two, let's say this variable will be, let's say 30, so, and we have also variable result. Remember that every line, every expression in JavaScript must be ended with this semicolon, and after that, let's say variable result addition will be number one plus number two, and this there is already built-in functions in JavaScript that enable us to inform the result, such as alert. So let's say alert result add and end this line. Now this script will have the ability to show the result of this addition. So if I have gone to my browser and opened this page and refreshed this page, you must see this alert. So alert function works as message box in any programming language desktop for like function in Java, let's say. So in Java there is function message box, which Java J option bin dot show message box. So this in JavaScript, this alert is defined variable in the browser which shows message box, which is different to any browser. The shape of this alert box is different across any browser. If I have okay, so this message will disappear, and if I refresh this again, it will show the same result in the alert. And we can also inform this the result in different ways. Let's say document dot write. So document dot write, let's say we will print the result add of this function. This will print a paragraph of this result. Let's refresh and it will show for us the result of this addition. We can also, let's say, result subtract will be number one minus number two, and also we have, let's say, document to the right result subtract. Also we have result, let's say multiply equal number one minus number two, and we have the ability to write this variable to the document and finish by having also another variable, let's say result divide will be number one minus number two, and also document dot write will inform this result to the viewer or the bed. So this three lines will inform three values. Let's refresh this bed. It will see them like that. Let's say the multiply will be multiplied and divide will be like that, and refresh again. It will be, so we have here number one. Here we will print multiply, and we will expect this result to know that all the variables in one line. So we will put here break tag. So document dot write, and here we have the break tag. Let's copy this line and paste it here. Alright, so we will refresh. So this is the result of subtract, multiply, and division. Another common rule in math, which is increment and decrement. Let's say we have variable number will be, let's say, 3, and let's say document dot write will increment number by 1, and we have also document dot write another line. Let's say this line will be break tag to divide our results, and also we will decrement these results. Document dot write, let's say number minus minus will decrement. So here we have increment, and this line will be decrement. Let's refresh our page. We expect that we have 4 and 2. Let's refresh these pages. So we have 3 and 4. So let's change it. Let's say we have another num. Let's say this will be 5, and increment, decrement num, and print the results and refresh our page. So to increment variables in JavaScript, you must do like that. The increment tag must be before the number, and here the decrement must be before the variable. And we have to refresh this page. We must see 3 incremented to 4 and 5 decremented to 4. Another important thing in JavaScript is working with string. So working with string is straightforward as working with numbers. Let's say variable first name will be, let's say, Camel, and variable second name will be also, let's say, Al-Tuhami. And another important thing to inform these results or concatenation these results. So we can, let's say, document dot write. Let's say we will print first name and concatenate this first name with second name. So this line will print the two results and refresh Camel and Tuhami. We can also make here space and like that. Let's save and refresh. Alright. So also we can print these results in the alert. Let's say alert first name, and here is the space, and also we have second name, and in this line like that, and refresh again. So we will alert this string like it concatenated by space. Another important thing in JavaScript is asking for information. So we have already built in function in JavaScript with the name of Promise. So this function takes the argument of string, we must ask the user for something like question. So what is your age? Or let's say like that. And so this function returns the result or the answer as a string. So we can save the result as string. Let's say variable age will be promised what is your age. After that, we can print this message or this variable. Let's say document.write my age is, and here is the age. Let's refresh this page. What is your age? Let's say 20. And here is the result. My age is 20. Let's run this again. What is your age? Let's say 15. And this prints the result. My age is 15. And this with the way to asking for information by using built-up function in JavaScript, which is the name of Brom. So that we have learned about variables and strings in JavaScript. In the next video, we'll explain how to working in arrays in JavaScript.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is the third video in JavaScript or JavaScript course. We are going to talk about how to define and working with arrays in JavaScript. So to define arrays in JavaScript, let's say we have days, so we can define that these days start with, let's say, Monday, and here we have also Tuesday, and we have Wednesday, and Thursday, and also we have Friday, and we have Saturday, and finally we have Sunday. So this is the, if we know the number of our array, we can define each variable or each element in our array like this. So the use of arrays is when we have some data or some element of the same type, you can define these variables like this. And we have also another option to define our variables in MBT list. We can define arrays of MBT like that. So playlist will be MBT. And another rule to define arrays in JavaScript, let's say we have days 2, we can say new array, and also we have, let's say, Saturday and Sunday and Monday, and also we can define array list of variables of the have the non type. Let's say we have variable preferences. Let's say these variables, first variable will 20 and second variable will be name, and another variable, let's say false, another variable will be the name of false, and we have, let's say, minus, this will be double. So this is variables of non-equal type. So this is the first part, is how to defining variables in JavaScript, and here is the part of accessing element in this array. So let's start. We want to access the variable, let's say Tuesday in this day. So we will alert days of, let's say 2, and here be sure that every array in JavaScript starts with zero base index. So Monday has the index of zero, and Tuesday has the index of one, and Wednesday has the index of two. So if your arrays like that day contain seven elements, so the final element will be six nor seven as the result of zero base indexing. So let's save this file and refresh. So if you refresh your page, you will see the message which have Wednesday as we have type days of two. It refers to this variable which has index of two. Let's try another variable, say four, and this will type Friday like that. Assume that you want to change element in array. So let's say days of zero will be Monday, and let's say console.log we will type the arrays in the console. Or you have another option to alert days of zero in the alert. So let's go and refresh, and this type the new value of first element which we have changed here. So assume that you want to access the last element in this array, so we'll alert the final element days dot length. So days, the array has the function of length which refers the length of this array like that. Alert days of length, and refresh again, it will say that length of this array of. And if we refresh again, we will see the real number of these array. And if we want to access the last element, let's say variable day will be days of days dot length minus one. This index will be seven. Will be six, which refers to final element, as we have started with zero base indexing, and we will type this day in alert function. Let's refresh this page. It will say seven. If we refresh again, let's save and refresh again. Let's save and refresh again. We have Sunday, which is the final element in this array. So the next section is to adding. Show how to adding element or item to this array. Let's say we have array of months, and this array have started with January, and after that February, and after that February, and after that we have March. So let's say we want to add April to this months. Let's say months of months dot length minus one will be two equals, let's say, April. This will replace March with April. We will delete minus one to add April in third index here, which is the four element, and we can alert after that months dot length, and let's refresh the page. We'll refresh someday. After that you will see four, which is the number of elements in this array. another important function to push elements into your array, which is built in JavaScript into your browser, which is push. And let's say we will add May to the final element, and after that you can alert months.length. Let's save and refresh Sunday, and here we have 5 elements after we have adding May to this array. You can also adding elements in the beginning of your array by saying, let's say months.upshift, and we will add to the beginning December. And if we save and refresh your page Sunday, and here you must say Sunday, you have wrong here, alert upshift. So the final part is seeing how to deleting elements from your array. So you have built in functions like Bob or Chef. You can after that alert the final length of your array. Let's comment this line. And remember that up to this moment we have 5 elements into months array. If you go to your browser and refresh this page, you will see that we have 3 elements after you deleted Bob. So this Bob function delete element from the end, and Shift function also delete element, but this function delete element from the beginning. And that was the function related to arrays in JavaScript. In the next video, we will explain how to process arrays in JavaScript.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number 5 in our JavaScript course. We are going to continue on what we have started in the previous video. So in this video, we are going to discuss the logic in JavaScript and how to add logic to your scripts or to your program. So before we start, let's say that we have variable text. Let's say this string will be my name is Al-Tuhami, and we are going to, so we are trying to print a character, let's say number 5 in the string. So we are going to say alert text dot character at, let's say 5, and close this character at. So text is object, is supposed, it's considered an object, and while this text is an object, so it has built-in functions into your browser. If you have Firefox or Chrome, so you have into your browser built-in functions that related to this text. So character s is function related to this text while it's string. So this function will print the character at 5 1 2 3 4 5. So this will print character at number 5. Let's save this document and open. If we have gone to our browser and refresh the page, it will print M not A because it starts with 0. So every accounting in JavaScript is started by 0 with indexing like Java or any programming language. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So M is number 5. If we have changed it to 0 and save our document and gone to our browser and refresh again, it will print M, which is the first character. Let's try another, let's say 2. We expect it will print empty character. Let's try it print empty character because it's space into 2. So it considers this space as character and has space into your counting. So let's discuss our, let's start our lesson. We are going to start
adding logic and controls. So to add logic, we have else if statement. So if, and here is the parentheses, if let's say age greater than 30, let's say alert, you are old man, and let's close this. So if the statement, and after the statement we have the bracket, and the bracket inside this bracket, this is a statement which is executed if this statement is true. To make this true, let's say age, variable age, define our variable age will be 45, and let's save our document and go to the browser, refresh the page. You are old man. So if we make the age less than 30, let's say 20, so if we refresh the page, nothing will be happened because this statement is false and nothing will be executed in this if statement. So here are some rules we will discuss, which are the operators. So we have convergence operators to test values. The first is equal to, this is equal to.
So I have paused this video until I write this operator. We have two equals, which is refers to equal to, and not equal to is defined by this. And we have greater than, less than, greater than or equal, less than or equal. All these operators seems defined for you, but the strange for you this new one, which is strict equal to. This, that means each variable or that you have which you are compare must be equal in type and value. Let's say we have 3 and 3, so this not equal to this because this is string or character, and this is integer. But if we say like that, so as I have mentioned, if we have, I have made example to show what this strict equal to means. So if we have variable x equals 3 as integer and the variable y equals 3 as string or character, so if I have said x strict not equal to y, it will print this statement. So already, if we are comparing to by this statement, so the type doesn't make sense for us, we compare the values. So inside this string, this value is 3 equal to 3, so this statement is true. But if we compare strict equal, we compare by using type or value. So this is string not equal to the type of this. So this is a string integer, and this statement is string. So this statement will be false. And if also we restrict and change, so this statement also will be false because these two variables not equal either in type or in value. Let's try another example. Variable, let's say enter color will be, let's say red, and if statement enter color will be red, we will run this script
document dot document dot body dot color dot style, we will change style dot background color will be, let's say, red. Else we will change the red to be blue, and we will discuss this else will be executed while this if statement is false. So we will save this document and go to this browser and refresh. It changes the background to red. And also if we change the entered color to something like yellow, it will become blue. All right, so this script run correctly. So let's have another example. Let's say variable money will be, let's say, 300. If money is greater than 100, alert, we will alert you are so rich, else alert good luck. All right, so we will this script will be saved in this document and run this in the browser. You are so rich because 300 is more than 100. And if this will be, let's say, 50 is less than 100, so good luck will be executed and alert in the document. So we will save this document and we expect that good luck will be alerted in this page. And that was the if and else statement and how to add logic to your scripts. In the next video, we'll explore new topic in JavaScript.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is video number 6 in our JavaScript course. We are going to discuss new topics in if and else statement and see more examples and see how to testing more than one condition. And also see how to use nested in if else. So we are going to see this new example. We have variable cash will be promised what, or let's say how much money do you have. After that, we will execute this if statement. If cash will be greater than 5, greater than or equal 5, so let's say alert go to cafe. So this example showing how to use else and if else statement, and also the meaning of this example. According to money you have, we will execute some statement. So else if provided us the ability to use another statement. So if else cash will be greater or equal than 15, so we will say alert go to, let's say, dinner. And also else if cash will be greater than or equal, let's say 40, so
alert go to cinema, and else means alert stay at home and go next Friday. So if we have if you have cash greater than 5 and less than 15, go to cafe. If you have cash greater than 15 and less than 14, so go to dinner. If you have money more than for 40, 100, 200, so go to cinema. If you have else or any cash else, so it will be less than 5 pound or $5, so stay at home and go next Friday. So of cash is 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, nothing, it will be executed here. Alert stay at home and go next Friday. And let's save this statement and go to our browser and save. It should prompt us with cash, let's say 2, and okay, so it's printed, stay at home and go next Friday. Let's try another thing, let's refresh and say we have cash is 15, and if we expect he will say go to cafe, and it's all right, so we say go to cafe. Let's refresh again and say we have 20 as our cash, and okay, so he say go to cafe. All right, so let's try another thing. Let's say we have 100 in our cash, so go to cafe. So there is something wrong into this program. So let's refresh again, and how much do you have? Let's say I have 45, go to cinema and refresh again. How much money do you have? I have, let's say 25, and refresh again. Go to dinner, let's refresh again. And how much money do you have? Let's say I have 10 pounds in my wallet, so he say go to cafe. And I find the solution for this problem is to start with the greater one. So if the cash is greater than 40, it will be executed, unless it will be gone here. So the right solution is to start with the greater value here, like I have made here. So this is the first part in this video about this example. Let's try how to testing more one condition into your so first we have some operators. First operator is OR operator. OR operator is defined by this, and also we have AND operator. AND operator is defined by this like that, and also we have NOT. So NOT is defined by, in every operator, NOT is defined by this expression. Let's have an example about these operators. Let's say we have variable number will be, let's say 20, and if let's say number is greater than or equal 5, and number will be less than 100, we will alert, let's say you have passed the exam, and so and will be true. All the statement will be true only if this is true and this is true. So if this first part of the statement will be true and this will be true, so the whole and all the expression will be true. And only if one statement will be false, so all the statement will be executed as false. let's try this in our browser, and I have saved our document and fresh, so you have passed the exam. So let's start by, let's say it will be 2, and let's make this 50, and let's say that will be 5. Alright, so we have gone to the browser, and if we refresh, nothing will be happened, and nothing will be represented here in this document, because 5 is less than 15, and that means this is false and this is true, so nothing will be happened, as because this whole statement is defined as false. Opposite to this statement is or. So or requires, or a statement requires only one part is defined as true, and all the statement will be defined as true only if one statement is defined as true. So let's try this. So 5, let's say 5 is alright, so 5 is less than 100. Alright, so we will refresh, and we must see this message, because 5 is less than 100. This part is true and this part is false, but or will make the magic happen, because this only if one part is defined as true. And that was the second part in our tutorial. The third part is to define the third part in our tutorial about to define nested loops. So we will discuss nested statement in if or nested conditions. So if, let's say, we will define variable num will be 40, and if num is greater than 30, if num is greater than 50, and num less than 16, also if num is greater than 16 and num is less than 17, we will run the statement if num greater than 17 and num is less than 90, if num is greater than 90 and num is less than 100. So here we will type or alert, you are good student, and imagine that number will be a degree of your exam. So if number is greater than 60, you are very good student. Let's say alert, you are, let's say, you are excellent student. After that, we will alert you or, let's say, genius or anything like that. And let's say number will be 75 also. Alright, so if we run this page, you are excellent student, because 75 or 76 is greater than 70 and less than 90. Let's say will be 98 we expect you are genius. All right, so if we say that will be 55, we expect you are good student. Let's refresh again, you are good student. And if we change this number and let's say this will be, and this number will be, let's say 40, nothing will be happened because this student will haven't succeeded the bus, and 44 is less than 50 and it will not go here and will ignore these statements. And that was the final part in this video. In the next part we will define,
and in the next video we'll explore tutorial and revision on if and else statements.